So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Okay, and someone was asking ki kya ye session state government state exam ke liye useful hai ya nahi. Of course these are useful. Okay, so let's begin with the session, but before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and you can also ask any doubt, and you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any question regarding exams. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, which country chaired the 18th India ASEAN summit? Very easy question and very very important question. See guys, in these summit type of questions, ye jo summit type ke questions hote hain, except UPSC, agar main UPSC ki baat nahi karta hu, so the detailed questions will not be asked from such summit, kyunki in summit mein generally kya hota hai, discussions hoti hai. In UPSC they can ask the outcomes of the discussion, the outcomes of the India ASEAN summit, but of course if your exam is objective, no detailed questions can be asked from any of the summit. All right, so is tarike ka hi koi question pucha ja sakta hai. This type of question can be asked from such summit if you are going for an objective exam. So the question is, which country chaired the 18th India ASEAN summit? So recently the 18th edition of India ASEAN summit was held and it was attended from India side by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And do remember that the summit was chaired by Brunei. Brunei was the chair of this 18th edition of India ASEAN summit. And the leaders announced the year 2022. The next year they have announced as the year of friendship, matlab India ASEAN friendship year. The year 2022 will be observed as India ASEAN friendship year as announced by the leader. Also remember that India has contributed medical supplies worth $200,000 to ASEAN's humanitarian initiative from Myanmar and $1 million for ASEAN's COVID-19 response fund. Do remember these amounts, $200,000, $2 lakh, you can say $2 lakh to ASEAN's humanitarian initiative of for Myanmar, and $1 million for ASEAN's COVID-19 response fund. And India will also provide support for the establishment of ASEAN cultural heritage list. ASEAN cultural heritage list. Okay. So isme itna hi padhna hai. Now let's come back to the question. The correct answer, guys, will be what? Option C. Now can you tell me what is the capital of Brunei? Brunei ki capital bata sakte ho? B se hi shuru hoti hai. Let me give you a hint. B se hi shuru hoti hai. And write down the name of the capital of Brunei. Question number 2 pe chalte hain. In which state or UT Apple Festival was inaugurated by Union Agriculture Minister? Now who is the Union Agriculture Minister? It's Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, Lok Sabha constituency is Morena. Has been organized for the first time. Kaun se state ya kaun se UT mein sabse pehli baar ये एप्पल फेस्टिवल ऑर्गेनाइज किया गया? सो द स्टेट द यूटी गाइज इज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, एंड फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम दिस एप्पल फेस्टिवल हैज बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इन द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. डू रिमेंबर दिस फैक्ट दैट एप्पल फ्रॉम जेएनके कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू 87% ऑफ द नेशनल प्रोडक्शन एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स लाइवलीहुड. द एप्पल प्रोडक्शन प्रोवाइड्स लाइवलीहुड टू अराउंड 30% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. ओके, सो इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है. जस्ट remember that this apple festival was organized in Jammu and Kashmir and it was inaugurated by Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. So the correct answer, guys, will be what? Option E, Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor is Mr. Manoj Sinha. Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha recently launched digital banking mission. They have launched Digital Banking Mission, One Gram Panchayat Digital Banking Mission. Digital Banking Mission, which is named as One Gram Panchayat One Sakhi. One Gram Panchayat One Sakhi. Kuch aisa hi naam hai, I'm forgetting the name. One Gram Panchayat One Something Sakhi Mission, aisa hi kuch hai. They have recently launched a Sukoon app. Sukoon app, which is 24/7 mental helpline number. They have recently launched Hausla Scheme. हौसला स्कीम भी अभी कुछ टाइम पहले उन्होंने लॉन्च करी थी. एंड अदर देन दिस दे हैव लॉन्च व्हाट, एक दो चीजें और थी जो कि हाल फिलहाल में ही लॉन्च हुई हैं यहाँ से. यस, तामीर तरक्की ऐप दे हैव लॉन्च्ड. तामीर तरक्की ऐप दे हैव लॉन्च्ड एन ऐप विच इज नोन एज प्रूफ. प्रूफ ऐप भी इन्होंने लॉन्च करी है. सो देर आर वेरियस थिंग्स बिकॉज ऑफ विच जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इज इन न्यूज. यू रिमेंबर ऑल द फैक्ट्स. एंड इसका नाम क्या था, मेरे को नाम याद नहीं आ रहा. डिजिटल बैंकिंग मिशन डैश वन ग्राम पंचायत वन समथिंग है. ओके चेक कर लेते हैं जल्दी से, दो मिनट लगेगा वरना रह जाएगा आपका भी और मेरा भी. यस सो द नेम वॉज यस वन ग्राम पंचायत वन डिजी पे सखी. वन ग्राम पंचायत वन डिजी पे सखी. कभी भी कोई चीज अटक गया तो उसको छोड़ना मत, वरना वो छोटा ही रह जाता है और वही चीज एग्जाम में आएगी, ध्यान रखना. वन ग्राम पंचायत वन डिजी पे सखी इज द नेम ऑफ द इनिशिएटिव दैट वाज लॉन्च्ड बाय लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर मनोज सिन्हा एंड दिस वाज द डिजिटल बैंकिंग मिशन. सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री. विद विच इंस्टीट्यूट महानदी कोल फील्ड्स लिमिटेड हैज साइन टू एमओयूज फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग स्किल डेवलपमेंट ट्रेनिंग टू द यूथ्स फ्रॉम द पेरिफेरल विलेजेस ऑफ माइनिंग एरियाज. व्हाट आर दीज पेरिफेरल विलेजेस? The villages which are located in the countryside, in the remote areas of a particular state, of a particular city. एक city के outer में अगर कोई village है तो those villages are known as what? Peripheral areas, peripheral villages. And these two MOUs, remember, have been signed with CIPET, which is Central Institute for Petrochemicals, Engineering and Technology, Bhubaneswar. Bhubaneswar में ये CIPET है, इसके साथ ये दो MOU साइन हुए हैं. Now the objective of these MOU is to develop the skill of the youth from the peripheral villages of mining areas. Mining areas के जो peripheral villages हैं वहाँ के youth का skill development किया जाएगा through these two MOUs. And remember these two MOUs have been signed under two CSR initiatives of Mahanadi Coalfields Limited which are Udaan and Sahyog. Udaan and Sahyog. Under Udaan, 40 youths from peripheral villages will join a 2-year full-time ITI training program. And under Sahyog, 30 persons with disabilities will join a 6-month long skill training program. Okay, and the total amount that will be spent in this is 1.38 crores. All right. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. The correct answer, guys, will be what? Central Institute of Petroleum, Petrochemicals, Engineering and Technology, CIPET, Bhubaneswar. Option A is the correct answer. क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर पे आ जाओ. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एआई पे चर्चा ऑन द थीम एआई फॉर डाटा ड्रिवन गवर्नेंस. एआई पे चर्चा इज नथिंग बट डायलॉग ऑन आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, डिस्कशन ऑन आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, एंड इट इज बीइंग ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी. एंड विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑर्गेनाइज दिस? दिस इज नेशनल ई गवर्नेंस डिवीजन. नेशनल ई गवर्नेंस डिवीजन इट इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय दिस. And do you remember the name of the initiative? AI pe charcha. And this time the theme was AI for data driven governance. AI for data driven governance is the theme. And National E-Governance Division under Ministry of Electronics and IT has organized this. ठीक है, इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. Just remember the name of the initiative. They can also ask that what is the name of the initiative which was organized by NEGD, National E-Governance Division, with the theme AI for data driven governance, and this initiative was focused on discussion on AI. So such type of question can also be asked. So in that case the answer would be what? AI pe charcha. Moving ahead to question number 5. The question based on loan, and in the Friday session I have told you that in the questions in the news of loan you just have to remember 3-4 things. Number 1, the objective of the loan. Number 2, the international bank which has given the loan. The state for which the loan is taken and the objective. ठीक है, ये and the amount. Objective, international bank, state and amount. These are the 4 things that you have to remember in case of news regarding loans. So for which city of Tamil Nadu government of India has signed a loan agreement worth $251 million for climate resilient integrated urban flood protection and management. And remember this loan agreement has been signed with ADB, Asian Development Bank. Headquartered in Manila, Philippines. So this city, guys, is Chennai. Option D, Chennai is the correct answer. So these 4 things. Number 1 is the state or the city for which the loan is taken. Number 2, the international bank, that is ADB. Number 3, the objective for climate resilient integrated urban flood protection and management. And number 4, of course, is the amount, $251 million. डॉलर्स. तो ऑप्शन डी चेन्नई इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 पे आ जाओ. द 6th एडिशन ऑफ नेशनल फॉर्मुलरी ऑफ इंडिया हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर मिस्टर मनसुख मंडाविया. विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज पब्लिश्ड इट. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस नेशनल फॉर्मुलरी ऑफ इंडिया बाय द वे, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. सो दिस वॉज द 6th एडिशन ऑफ नेशनल फॉर्मुलरी ऑफ इंडिया. एंड दिस नेशनल फॉर्मुलरी ऑफ इंडिया गाइज, इट प्रोवाइड्स गाइडेंस टू द क्लिनिशियंस एंड द हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल्स. To the clinicians and the health professionals regarding what? This guidance is providing regarding what? Regarding three things. Regarding content, impact and side effect of medicines. Content, impact and side effect of medicines and thereby promoting the rational use of medicines. Okay? And also remember, it has been published by National Pharmacopoeia Commission. National Pharmacopoeia Commission has published this. Okay? So, इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. यू नीड नॉट गो इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस नेशनल फॉर्मुलरी ऑफ इंडिया बिकॉज दैट विल बी ऑफ नो यूज फॉर योर एग्जाम. सो कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन देन. ऑप्शन सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन सी बिकॉज द क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज पब्लिश्ड इट. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. वन सेकेंड. यस, Union Health Minister has addressed, again, Mr. Mansukh Mandaviya has addressed the inaugural session of CII Asia Health Summit 2021. What was the theme of the summit? One thing is clear that this summit was with respect to the health. ठीक है, ये health के respect में था, because the name suggests CII Asia Health Summit. And who is the chairperson of CII? It's Mr. T.V. Narendran. T.V. Narendran is the chairperson of CII for this year 2021. And you remember the theme for this summit, guys, was transforming healthcare for a better tomorrow. Option A, transforming healthcare for a better tomorrow was the theme of CII Asia Health Summit. And in this particular summit, there was a speech of Dr. Jitendra Singh also, Minister of Science and Technology and Earth Sciences. So option A is the correct answer. And as I told you, in such summit, no detailed question can be asked. First type of question can only be asked from these type of summits. Okay, so option A is the correct answer. Question number 8. What is the theme of Urban Mobility Conference 2021 being organized by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs? In this conference also, guys, there was no necessary thing. Matlab, not required type ki cheeze thi isme, jo ki exam point of view se important nahi hai. Because it was just a conference. It was just a conference. So, here in this news also, you just have to remember Urban Mobility Conference was organized by which ministry. Aur ye bhi yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, when you see the word urban, then definitely the ministry should be the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. Hardeep Singh Puri, and he is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Theek hai? So the theme of this conference was mobility for all. Option B, mobility for all is the correct answer. Question number 9 pe aa jao. Which campaign is being organized by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment for distribution of aids and assistive devices to divyang jan or person with disabilities under the ADIP scheme? ADIP scheme ke under kaun sa campaign organize kiya jata hai to distribute the assistive living devices to the PWDs, person with disabilities? The campaign, guys, is Samajik Adhikarita Shivir. Option A, Samajik Adhikarita Shivir. And also remember, this is not being organized only at a one place. It is being organized all over the country so that these assistive living devices will be distributed equally to all the person with disability, to all the eligible person with disabilities across the country. Okay, so option A is the correct answer. Question number 10, which is the last question. State Rural Livelihood Missions of 5 states facilitated the CXO meets. Now, CXO, guys, is a term which is used for all the top-notch employees of a company. Top-notch matlab CEO, CTO, CMO, COO. So, all these together are known as what? CXO. Okay? And the meet is known as CXO meets. CXO meet mein kya hoga? Jitne bhi top-notch employees honge, wo sare ke sare participate karenge of any particular company or organization. CXO meets under DDU GKY, Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Grameen Kaushalya Yojana, for establishing new industry linkages, ensuring candidates to get suitable employment opportunities. Which of the following is not one of the 5 states? So let's talk about the news first. What is the news? CXO meets are being organized, or you can say have been organized under DDU-GKY. And these meets, ye jo meets hai, CXO meets, they were focused, they serve as a platform. They were focused on providing a platform for establishing new industry linkages, ensuring better employment opportunities to the youth under DDU-GKY. ठीक है, DDU-GKY के अंडर जो यूथ है उनको इंडस्ट्री से लिंकेज कराने के लिए क्या क्या चीजें होनी चाहिए उसके रिगार्डिंग डिस्कशन था इन दीज CSO मीट्स. ठीक है, एंड दीज CSO मीट्स वर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय स्टेट रूरल लाइवलीहुड मिशन ऑफ 5 states. 5 states के SRLMs ने इनको ऑर्गेनाइज किया था, विच आर असम, झारखंड, MP, तमिलनाडु एंड गुजरात. असम, झारखंड, MP, तमिलनाडु एंड गुजरात, दीज आर द 5 states फ्रॉम विच SRLMs have organized these CXO meets. All right, and CXO yaad rakhna, the top notch employees. So which of the following is not one of the 5 states? Assam is there, Jharkhand, MP, Tamil Nadu, UP nahi hai, Gujarat hai. So UP will be the correct answer. Option D, UP is the correct answer. And that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.